The area highlighted in green represents the iliotibial band. There is an avulsion fracture at its attachment site. So the question arises, should we call this an iliotibial band avulsion fracture? Let's briefly review the anatomy of the iliotibial band. It is a thick facial band running along the lateral aspect of the thigh. The iliotibial band consists of two main layers with distinct distal insertions. The superficial layer, highlighted in green, is the primary tendinous component and inserts onto Gerdy's tubercle on the anterolateral tibia. The deep layer, marked in pink, connects the superficial layer to the lateral supracondylar tubercle of the femur. Now returning to today's case. While it might initially appear to be an iliotibial band avulsion fracture, this is, in fact, a classic Segond fracture. The diagnosis of a Segond fracture can be made relatively easily based on its characteristic location and shape on imaging studies. The key is understanding the anatomy of the anterolateral ligament tibial insertion. It is located at the midpoint between the fibular head and Gerdy's tubercle, approximately 4 to 7 mm below the tibial plateau. If you see a thin, ovoid, vertically oriented bony fragment positioned anterolaterally or laterally along the lateral tibial plateau, but posterior to Gerdy's tubercle, this is a Segond fracture. Diagnosing small or non-displaced Segond fractures, however, can sometimes be tricky. A couple of key points about Segond fractures. First, while named after the anterolateral ligament, a Segond fracture may involve other lateral soft tissue structures such as the iliotibial band and the biceps femoris tendon. Specifically, the posterior fibers of the iliotibial band and distal anterolateral ligament are often avulsed together in a Segond fracture. According to a 2015 skeletal radiology study, both the iliotibial band and the anterolateral ligament may be involved in a Segond avulsion, whereas the anterior arm of the biceps femoris tendon is not typically involved. The structure highlighted in blue here is the anterior arm of the biceps femoris tendon. However, in cases of very large Segond fractures, there is potential involvement of the anterior arm of the short head of the biceps femoris tendon. Second, Segond fractures are recognized as markers of anterolateral rotatory instability of the knee and are frequently associated with severe ligamentous injuries, most commonly involving the anterior cruciate ligament, ACL. The images used in this case are from Visualizing MSK Radiology. If you're a member of my YouTube channel, you can access additional content and resources via Notion. Thank you for watching.